Welcome to Redtastic. Story 1. I-39 female have a vacation house that I let my sister, 31 female, and her husband, 34 male, use recently for a vacation with their kids. She has 3 kids under the age of 5, so I knew she could use the break to de-stress. And since they don't do well financially, I thought it would be a nice gesture. I gave them the keys with only one request: to clean up after themselves when they leave. They returned from their vacation, and everything seemed fine. Yesterday, though, I got a call from my aunt while she was on her way to my vacation house. I was completely confused since they had never informed me beforehand, and I definitely didn't give her the keys. When I asked, she said she got the keys from my sister. I dug a little deeper and found out that my sister had made a set of keys for herself, made extra copies, and then gave them to a few close family members. I was shocked and furious. I called my sister and we had a big fight. I told her she had no right to do that and that she was completely out of line. She argued back, saying I was being selfish for not wanting to share the house with family, and she claimed that I was acting like I was above everyone else. I told her I wasn't a charity and that it was my property, so I had every right to control who stayed there. Now things are really tense between us. I ended up calling my aunt back to explain the situation, and she said that my sister had a point, that I could be more generous with my family. Since she was already en route, I let her stay at the vacation house this time, but I'm really upset about the whole situation, and I'm not sure if I handled it correctly. Am I an ass for being upset that my sister made copies of my keys and gave them out without asking? Update: I decided to take a sudden trip to my vacation house on my own, and while I was there, I changed all the locks. I didn't tell anyone that I changed the locks. It's nobody's business but mine. It's my property, and I felt like I needed to take control back after what my sister did. I wasn't comfortable with the idea that just anyone in the family could be coming and going as they pleased. Things are still pretty tense between me and my sister. I've heard that she's been going around blasting me to anyone who will listen, calling me selfish and saying I'm trying to cut off the family. My dad called me recently, and I was expecting him to side with her, but instead, he expressed his displeasure at my sister's actions. He agreed that she was acting entitled and said that she had crossed the line. It was the only support I got in this issue. Honestly, this is it for me. No good deed goes unpunished, and I've learned my lesson. This will be the last time my sister or her family gets anything from me. I tried to do something nice and it backfired. She can stick it up where the sun doesn't shine. You're not an ass, OP. Your sister is. You were trying to be nice and do something for her, but she found a way to ruin it for herself. She had no right to share the key to your property with family without your permission. She doesn't understand the kind of damage that could be done to a house like that when a lot of people have access to it. And I'm sure she wouldn't offer to pay for damages if any of the people she gave your keys to ruin anything. She just seems like that kind of person. She's an entitled a-hole, and I'm glad you've changed the locks. She doesn't deserve anything from you, especially if she can't understand why you're mad at her. Until she gets it and offers an apology, you don't have anything to do with her. Story 2. Hello, I-25 female have been paying my boyfriend, 27 male's rent and including my own for 2 months at the moment. Going on 3. I didn't find this a problem until I started my finances tumbling down. I kept the amount of rent he had to pay, since it's a joint rent with my brother and his girlfriend. I pay 900 plus for the both of us in the apartment plus utilities. Kind of a secret because I did not want to make him feel bad, so I've been in a tight spot recently. He went off on me the other day about how he hasn't seen my bank account and finds me suspicious. I told him that right now I have been saving and funds are tight. He wouldn't believe me. In mid-argument, I said the amount I was paying and how I barely got any money left to pay for food at times due to my bills. He got very angry. He ignored me and said to treat him like he was my friend, that the amount that I was paying for him was unreasonable and that he wants to move out, and that I lied to him about the current circumstances I was in and should have told him the truth. He's literally angry about me not holding it against him financially. Now he wants me to confront my brother, the apartment holder, and say that it's bullshit and that I'm going to move out into my boyfriend's place. I don't want to move out and tell my brother that I've been paying for my boyfriend. My brother would be bummed out knowing that his sister has been paying for her boyfriend's share, so I would rather not have my boyfriend be in a bad light. What would you do? Edit. He didn't have a job, so I would cover for dates rent plus. Then recently, he got a job that pays twofold of what I make a month. He doesn't want to pay rent even now that he has money to pay for it. I didn't have a problem paying for his rent, but he went off on me because he found out the amount I was paying and wanted me to leave my place to move into his mother's for free. I won't be close to school. I would be counting on him and only him for rides. He also lives in a bad area, so I would be an hour away from family overall. He pays for food now, but is kind of reluctant too. Update. Hello, I have an update. I didn't want to come home last night because he was trying to force me to tell my brother, landlord, that I have been paying for his rent and that it's not fair that it's so expensive. I pay for both of us. He is angry about the amount I pay. He wants me to move out with him in his mother's house. I don't want to abandon my university. I would be living an hour away, counting on him for car rides. I told him that I was unhappy in the relationship and that he's being very rude. He started to guilt-trip me. Note, he has a problem with gaslighting. I told him no and that I did not want to move out against my own will since this is close to my school and I have no car. He got very angry. He started to say that I was very selfish and not willing to take this relationship forward. He said I was an idiot with no common sense, that I was selfish and only thinking about my own interests. I told him to stop calling me names. He didn't. He said, "I don't give an F about what you say. You're an idiot for not taking a stand. You're ruining the relationship. You have no brain cells to compute the fact that you are not taking a stand for yourself." I told him to just pay the rent. Help me get out of this financial situation since he has the money now. He said no. He said he would never sink that low into paying for rent. He started to go off on a tangent about how shitty of a person I am. He says he hates that I wear nice clothes now, jeans and a nice sweater, necklace, a choker, and put perfume on. He says I'm suspicious and that since I lied to him about the financial crisis, he can't trust me with anything else. I have not cheated on him. He said, "How can I grow as a human being if I continue to hide things and not tell the truth? I just don't want to tell my brother that I am paying his rent." He left for the night, didn't say I love you, and was very rude. I was very sad. He came back and treated me like I was some sort of sex toy, and once he was done, he just went to sleep and didn't treat me like a girlfriend. I am very sad that this is happening. I tried to be understanding and I made a mistake. I need help. He made me feel guilty for saying that I was unhappy in the relationship. I think it's time to break it off, but I'm scared too. What do you recommend? Last update. I'm going to build a safety net. I will be trying to gather as many friends and include my family in the situation. I'm very sad, but it must be done. I can't breathe without him, but I have to. My future, my classes, and my life right now is at stake. Thank you all for your help. Bless you all for responding. Thanks for your honesty and your kindness. I'm happy I posted. I'm happy I know what must be done and move forward. Your boyfriend is a very huge red flag, OP. and I seriously hope you dump him and never have anything to do with him ever again. He has done a number on your self-confidence and your self-esteem. Even after all the shitty things he has done, you're still with him and you obviously still care about him. Anyone who's not in this relationship knows you shouldn't be with that guy. He sucks. He's using you and no, he doesn't care about you. Anyone who cares about you would not call you names and treat you like shit just because they're mad about the amount you're paying for their rent. I totally agree with talking to your family and friends. They'll help you get through this and away from this man. Now for some comments. I recommend kicking him out ASAP, calling your brother, and yeah, be honest about what's going on with you and what I hope is going to be your shitty abusive ex. You don't need this abuse. You don't need this at all. You deserve so much better. You're none of the things he called you. And in fact, he was projecting his own failures and flaws onto you. It may be hard to do so, but you really need to leave this piece of shit. I've been in your shoes. It doesn't get any better, only worse. You can do so much better. There are tons of people out there that would not even dream of treating their girlfriend, who essentially pays for everything, the way he treats you. I don't understand. He should be extremely grateful that he has you doing all this for him, something most people, including myself, would never do. Instead, he's acting like an entitled brat. Let's flip this. If he really loved you, do you think he would be treating you this way? Ditch the narcissist. He will always be negative, envious, and act like a victim instead of working for what he wants. They will project all their shortcomings and faults onto you, and everything will be your fault somehow. While they simultaneously have to one-up you in any topic or label it as dumb and shut it down. Start verbal and get physical. You're already paying his rent. Before long, he would expect you to fork over your entire paycheck. If he got you further from family, it makes it that much easier to hide your bruised body and shame. Leave him while you're young and kids aren't involved. Think of something you've really wanted to do or see. Save the other half you used to put towards rent and treat yourself.